Welcome back. The next thing I'd like to discuss is the process of what we're going to call the meditative moment. That is to say, for every lecture, remember each lecture is going to be broken up into about five or six different segments. For every lecture, we're going to have a brief meditative moment, 3, 4, or 5 minutes, in which I'll just be asking you to sit, contemplate while doing something like breathing or some other meditative activity. And the idea is going to be this, to begin to understand aspects of your mind that might not be filled with or primarily about the thinking that fills our daily lives. Think about the ways in which your daily life is full of experiences like, I better return that email, or I have to remember to write that check that's overdue, or I wonder whether I offended her when I said that, or I sure wish I could find something better to eat than this. All the things we say to ourselves in the course of the day is very important. It's a very crucial aspect of getting through life. But there's an aspect, a dimension, a level of your mind that you can access, I believe, that is different from all those things, different from what I'd like to call the chatter of consciousness. The chatter of consciousness is important, but there's a part of you that's not that. And our meditative moment will be in part helping you to try to understand that, to become aware of it, to appreciate it. And then when you can begin to be aware of the chatter of consciousness, I believe that also you can make yourself more calm, more focused, more able to concentrate. You can forget about the various distractions, technologically driven, momentary bits of excitement or focus, and just rather focus on things that are about existing, about being aware, and hopefully also about understanding. So, every time we've got a lecture, you'll be spending a couple minutes, I hope, doing a bit of a meditative moment, and the idea will be to not just learn about an aspect of your mind that we'll be talking about in this class in a first-hand, first-person experience kind of way, but also in order to help you be more calm, be more focused, be more alert to what's going on in the here and now. And part of the reason I think this is very important is that nowadays, for many, many people in the world, we are so distracted by not just the fact that we're busy, but so distracted by so many technological innovations that it's easy to think that that's all there is to life, but I believe that would be a mistake. So I want you to begin to focus on those aspects of things that can be important in a person's life that are not about your iPod, iPad, tablet computer, music video, music, or anything else, but rather just about being conscious. So that's what I want to focus on now. Now today, what I want to focus on first, in order to get you a little bit of experience with that, is the process known as bamboo breathing. Now here's a big piece of bamboo that my daughter and I harvested from a little forest behind our house. And what I want you to notice about this piece of bamboo is that it's got segments. 1, 2, 3. It's hollow inside. This is going to be hollow between these two segments. Likewise, this is going to be hollow between these two. But these segmentations are going to be important for us for the following reason. Not only do they help us understand what makes the bamboo so strong, but also they help us understand a form of breathing that can be very calming, very relaxing, and very conducive to concentration. And it's called, as you might have guessed, bamboo breathing. So here's how bamboo breathing works. You'll take a fairly deep breath, not so big that it hurts, but you'll fill up with your lungs with air, and then you'll slowly exhale. And as you slowly exhale, you kind of exhale in segments, like the segments of this piece of bamboo. So every time you exhale in a segment, I want you to think about this or some other piece of bamboo and notice that it's broken up into segments just like the exhalation of air. That is, don't let all the air out of your lungs at once. Let it out in little pieces. And after you've done that, maybe after 4 or 5 little exhalations, you'll want to take a breath back in, hold it for a little while, maybe a second, and then do it again. So I hope you'll be able to hear me as I do this, but I'm going to try to model it for you, and then I'll ask you to do it as well after I use the meditation bowl to give us a little bit of sound to help us concentrate as well. So I'm going to take a breath in, and then I'll be slowly, segmentally letting it out. And I'll do it again. Hold it for a moment. I'll do it a third time. That That's all there is to bamboo breathing. And if you do that for about 2, maybe 3 minutes, I believe you'll find yourself calming down, focusing, forgetting about all the distractions of everyday life, and thinking about what our work together is going to be in this class, as well as perhaps use that skill more generally for as a method of relaxation. All right, so what I'm going to do next is try to support the meditative moment via the bamboo breathing with a little bit of sound. You've seen this before from the trailer for the course. This is a meditation bowl. And what I'm going to be doing is letting it do a little bit of singing. And then after it sings, we will be listening to it. And once I start, what I want you to do is, once I start with the music from this bowl, I want you to think about this bamboo and take a breath and slowly let it out in pieces corresponding to the segments of the bamboo. All right? Now take a deep breath. And exhale in segments. Very good. Before moving on to the next segment, what I'd like to do is suggest that you try that on your own, visualizing the piece of bamboo. Find yourself a place that's not distracting, not too loud, not too many other things going on, and practice the bamboo breathing, and I'll see you again in a moment.